Hello dear friends, today we'll discuss about the outcome of the entire course, and that outcome is the commercialization of the aspect of the medicinal attribute from the entire plant world. As we have gone through hundreds of the plants where the medicinal properties are residing, and those plant products and plants are available in our area, so many of the countries are taking this advantage of the properties present in the plants, and they are commercializing it and selling it as the medicine, as the drug. So we, the Indians, are having the huge wealth of this biodiversity, having the medicinal properties. So let we harvest that property and make it commercialized, and that commercialization of the entire plant world is supposed to be for establishment of the industries. So these industries are the agro-based industries, and that agro-based industries are especially because of the medicinal plants, and these are supposed to be the medicinal firms. So we have the huge sectors wherein the industrial area can be built up, but here I am highlighting some of the areas where you will find that major contribution of these industries will be there, that are agro and the food processing. Secondly, it is the pharma and biotech companies which are sharing the maximum share of the industries. Thirdly, tourism and wildlife or medicinal tourism. Or last one, that is the education. In all these industries, whatever industries are highlighting on the screen, that all the industries are sharing the good amount of economy in the industries. So these medicinal plants are contributing in all these industries, and that's why we can say that these medicinal plants are the source of the business startups. So because of this opportunity, I'm here to share with you that how we can go for the commercialization and what are the legal aspects in this area. So my dear friends, today we'll discuss about the medicinal properties. So for that purpose, we have to scan, we have to see the entire plant world in a special way, in a special vision, and that vision will be scanning the entire biodiversity for its medicinal properties. And if we are getting the medicinal properties, then definitely we have the opportunity to develop the commercial products out of it. So here it is the Indian scenario, wherein Indian scenario is handled, or entire potential of the medicinal plants will be harvested by the Indians, and that is regulated and that is advanced by our government of India under the Ministry of Ayush. Ayush is the abbreviation actually, which includes Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, then Unani Medicine, then Siddha and Homeopathy. These all are the pathies which are there in our history, and that all are based on the medicinal plants. So dear friends, this Ayush Mantralaya, this Ayush ministry is completely devoted and dedicated to harvest the benefits out of the plant world. So because of this special setup of the Ayush Mantralaya, now we have got the additional strength in this area. So this Ayush is working for the establishment of the knowledge base for the medicinal plants and their attributes, and how we can go for utilization of its medicinal properties to the max. That all will be handled by this Ayush Mantralaya, and this Ayush Mantralaya has set up one plant board that is called as the National Medicinal Plant Board, which is developing the E-Charak dashboard. This E-Charak dashboard is the dashboard wherein you will find the information of each and every medicinal plant having the medicinal attributes and having the potential to develop the modern drug. So dear friends, this Charak, E-Charak, is the website wherein we can have the entire information, or if we have the new information with respect to the medicinal plant, we can submit it to this. So this E-Charak is working under the National Medicinal Plant Board, which is working under the Ministry of Ayush. So this National Medicinal Plant Board is the board which is taking care of this entire business. Business in the sense that it will harvest the information from the entire nation and getting it converted into the product. That product may be the drug, that product may be the medicinal property of any plant. So dear friends, we have the huge wealth of the medicinal plants, and these medicinal plants are richest in the India, and that's why we are supposed to be the richest country in the biodiversity, having the medicinal wealth. Now this medicinal wealth is giving us the separation of the entire area in the 15 agroclimatic zones with the different climatic conditions and the different flora and fauna. And because of this, we have got the specialized plants in the special areas, and this is the attribute which are used in variety of the industries set up in the specific areas. Out of 17,000 to 18,000 species of the flowering plants reported in the area, more than 7,000 species are reported for their properties as the medicine. So you can imagine that how huge a number of plants we have with the medicinal properties. So this number is further evaluated for its medicinal properties which are commercialized. Mind well, this 1178 plant species are commercialized and they are in the trading. So this is the good number, and because of this we can say that we have harvested the good amount of wealth from the nature and taken for its advantage for a human being or mankind. 242 species have annual consumption level of in excess of 100 metric tons per year. You can see here that how huge amount of medicinal plants are used in the drug industry. So dear friends, with respect to this entire value, this is the figure in the year 2014 and 15, that we have exported the wealth of around 3211 crores of rupees out of this medicinal wealth. So how huge potential is there in this diversity, that we can formulate with the respect to this data. This is the data taken from one paper which was published in the year 2013. The demand of the medicinal plants and its supply. This position is clarified by the National Medicinal Plant Board. This National Medicinal Plant Board was working with the particular agency which was there in the New Delhi, that was Center for Research Planning and the Action in New Delhi. Secondly, it was having the assistance from the Foundation of Rehabilitation of Local Health Tradition, that is abbreviated as FRLHT, which was there in the Bangalore, and right now it is the exhaustive work of the ICFRE, that is the Indian Council of Forestry Research and Education. This agency is completely surveying the entire biodiversity throughout the India and evaluating its properties for the medicinal purpose, and the data will be submitted to the National Medicinal Plant Board for its further applications. So overall, these all agencies are contributing the huge efforts for getting the properties of the plants and then taking it at the commercial level. So medicinal plant industries which are there in the India, that we need to understand how this medicinal plant industry we can set up. Here you can see that nearly 960 plant species are used by the Indian herbal industries. This is the huge number, and that is, this number is only that number which was exhaustively used. The minor usages are not included in this figure. So this is the wealth having the huge turnover of the 80 billion turnover is there, and these industries which are there in this particular setup, they are producing the products. That products are applicable in the variety of the pathies. That may be Ayurveda, that may be Yoga, that may be Siddha, that may be Unani or Homeopathy. So because of this, it is said that they are the Ayush products. And these Ayush products are sharing the total 3% of the entire export in the pharmaceutical field. So it is the good contribution of the plant wealth. Then this particular plant wealth is giving us the revenue of 10 billion per annum. And this entire scenario is giving us the figure that 30% of the export consists of the finished products. Whatever we are exporting, that products are the finished products, means we are completely processing the information, formulating the drug and getting it into the form of the modern medicine, and that we are exporting as the herbal extracts or as the medicines. So this is the good contribution of the India in the global market as far as the medicinal plants are concerned. So this entire wealth, though we are saying that this is the huge wealth, but it is very remarkable to understand that it's only 1% of the entire market export. So we have a lot of scope in this area to work, to contribute. My dear friends, here you can see the graph, how our industries are working. And in this case, you will be able to see that this entire industry is following some practices. That practices are called as the good manufacturing practices. And if we see the good manufacturing practices, then we have hundreds of the problems in this area. And because of that problems, we are not producing or we are not harvesting the complete wealth of the available plants. So this is possible with respect to all these parameters. Whatever parameters are there, that will be available with you in the slide, and you can see the complete chart. I'll not spend much more time on the chart, but you will be able to see that in which area we are good, in which area it is needed to have the modifications, it is needed to have the greater contribution and rectification of the things, rectification of the practices. But the thing is, we have good amount of potential to harvest. At the same time, we have a lot of scope for improvisation. So this is the graph which is there to help you to find out the parameters wherein we need the improvisation, and where we are good, that is also shown in the graph. So let me understand what exactly are the issues for the standardization of the raw material, whatever raw material is available with us. So there is very good and important issue that we should focus on the contamination part, because whenever we are collecting the material, that collection of the material and processing will lead to have some sort of a contamination. So we need to take care that our material should not be contaminated with any kind of the pathogen or any kind of the organism. Secondly, 50% of the companies which are working in this area, they are facing the huge problem, and that problem is the authentication. Authentication should be done at the first step, because if you have used any wrong material, any wrong plant or plant part, then definitely it is not giving you a benefit. Alternatively, it may lead to some false information in some false effects. So that is the major threat in this area. That's why it is very important to have the proper authentication of the plant material. Then 36% of the industries having the problem of the adulteration of the raw material, because many of the times what is happening, that the material is collected, but that material is having the adulteration mixture, and that mixture has led to the minimization of the particular benefit of the plant. Then this is the very important to understand, that many of the plants are contaminated or having the upliftment of the heavy metals. And if those heavy metals are there in the plants, then definitely that plants will have the changed properties. So we need to take care that whatever area we are using for collection of the plant material, that should not have any kind of the influence of the heavy metals, and that heavy metals may be entering into the plant by the natural course of action, or that may be accidental entry of the medicine particular heavy metals into the plant body. So we should take care, because this is the problem with many of the industries. Lastly, the microbial contamination. Many of the plants cultivated or they are harvested from the forest area, they are having the inclusion or infection of the microbes, and these microbial infections are altering the properties of the plant. So this is also important issue which we need to handle, which we need to tackle at the initial stage of the application of the plants. So let me understand what exactly are the good manufacturing practices. So if we would like to manufacture any kind of a drug, then we should have specific manufacturing practice. So in case of this good manufacturing practice, there are different techniques available through which if we go, then definitely we will have the better outcome. First, it is the application of the chemical fingerprinting. We should formulate the complete profile of the chemicals found in the plants. That's why this chemical fingerprinting and the marker based assessment of the raw material is very necessary. And for this purpose, there is the molecular based assessment at the taxonomic point of view. Secondly, this will be at the chemical level, this will be at the genomic level, or finally this will be at the proteomic level. So these parameters means, first it is the taxonomic, second it is the chemical, third it is the genetical, and fourth it is the proteomic. So all these parameters will be helpful for getting the specific good quality of the plant material. And because of this practices followed by many of the industries, we could achieve the good number of plants giving us the better medicines. And that's why this kind of the practices, this kind of the follow-ups should be there for every plant. In case of the India, we have the regulation of this particular business, that is commercialization of the medicinal plant. In case of this, the one major act which is coming into force, that is the Drug and Cosmetic Act, which was enforced in the year 1940, and it was amended in the year 2004, and that is the fourth amendment of this act, and that act has provided the specific set of rule for usage of the medicinal plants, and they have categorized the plants on the basis of their properties and their applications. First, it was the group for plants which can be used as the aqueous extract in the medicine. Secondly, they are the hydroalcoholic extract based drugs. So in both the cases, there is a specific requirement to satisfy, and that requirements are the studies which should be conducted at the clinical trial level, at the safety level, at the efficacy level. So overall, safety, efficacy, and the specifically its usage should be studied extensively. When this hydroalcoholic extracts, like we have studied the decoction, this decoction is not supposed to be the part of the Ayurvedic medicine, because this is not following the basic practice of the Ayurveda. And in this case, there should be validation of the entire claim if we are claiming some medicinal property after the extraction through the decoction process. So this is the four kinds of plants which we can use in the variety of the industries. These are the top industries which are there in the India, which are harvesting the natural wealth and getting it in the form of a commercialized products. These are the top 10 companies. You can see here the Hamdard, Baidyanath, Dabur, then Imami, Zandu, Himalaya, Vico, all these companies are having the huge cultivation of the plants and used it in the production of the medicines. So wherever we are finding that this is the plant which we have and we can use it as the medicine, for that entire process we need to go through the commercialization process, in which the very important and first and foremost step is the study of the literature and the entire knowledge base. That must be the traditional knowledge and the modern knowledge base. for analyzing the properties of the plants. Second important one, that what exactly is the value there in the plant, that is called as the bioprospecting, in which we will analyze that these are the properties which can be used for the production of the medicine. Then whatever were the claims in the literature, that has to be validated well by using different validation tools. Then after validation of the entire material and got confirmation that this plant is having the specific medicinal value, then we will go for the selection of that particular species, and then selected species will be cultivated. Mind well that we will not be dependent on the natural availability of the plant. If we would like to use the plant, then we have to cultivate it. And once we have cultivated and got the enormous amount of the plants, then only we can use that. Otherwise, many of the industries are working in the fashion like they are harvesting the material from the forest area and using it for their own purpose. But this will not be allowed in the regulation. After cultivation, the plant processing will be the next step. That processing will be either that will be purification of the material and then extraction of the material, then processing the biomolecule for its formulation of the drug, which will be the process called as the drug development. So, dear friends, this all is the process which is there in the commercialization of the particular plant material. So, with reference to the flow chart, with reference to all these parameters, if you work in this line, then definitely by means of the rules and regulations in the India, prevailing in the India, you will be able to commercialize one plant product in your name, and a single product from the plant having the specific application can make you millionaire. So, dear friends, just use the traditional knowledge, apply your scientific temper and the knowledge to commercialize the material. This will give you the good opportunity for establishing the small startup, having the ability to grow into the multinational market capturing industry. So, wish you all the best for this. Thank you very much for participation in this course. Thank you very much.